Hello everyone, welcome to Paper Craft Mix. It's me, Brigitta, and you are watching a video in which I have some Easter and spring inspiration for you. Right in front of me I have the three paper pads that I used mostly on the projects I'm going to show to you today. And this is the first one. Well, it's the cover because I finished this paper pad. I only think I have one and a half sheet left with the prints I did not like so much, so I'm not going to use that. And that was the Simple Stories Hip Hip Hooray. I used my last leftovers to make some embellishments with. The other Easter paper pad that I'm working with right now is this one from Cartabella, Here Comes Easter. That's the only line that I purchased this year for my Easter crafting. Love the colors, pastel colors, cute images. Wonderful paper pad. And the last one I used in the project for today is this one. It's from Echo Park, Little Ladybug. So cute with the little ladybugs, but also with nice florals. Beautiful summery primary colors. I've had a lot of fun creating with that paper pad as well. So let us start. It's a little bit of this and that. I didn't pull out all the dies because I used so many, but I will tell you from which brand they are. And the first ones I'm going to show you are cute little bunnies that I made. And you will all probably recognize them. I made them with a die and a stamp set from KS Crafts. You can make them in pattern paper, in plain cardstock. You can put them on anything that you want. I don't know where I'm going to use them for, but I do think they are so adorable. Look, this is the first one. You're extra special. I give them a little bow in their hair with the flat back pearl. I stamped in brown because I didn't want the hush black with all the pastel colors. I did use some glittery paper for the eyes and for the background of the sign with the text. Really, really cute, adorable, and it's a nice size to use on something. That's the first one that I did, and of course I couldn't do one. I did the pink version, bunny kisses. How cute are these? And a green version, and for the base I only used simple white cardstock. So that are my little bunnies. And with another die from KS Craft I did make the Easter banners or flags. I made two of them. For this you need the base die from summer, from last year. I already told and showed that numerous times, but this year for Easter you can buy this one with the cutouts of the flowers and with the Easter words. In my previous video where I showed some spring Easter embellishments, I showed all the text, all the words that come with this die set. So if I remember, I will put a link here so that you can look it up, or in the description box. I went a little bit further. I put them on a straw and I decorated the front or the top of the straw with a cute little flower from my stash. I had them for quite some time and I thought they were cute here because of the how is this called, the organza that's also attached to the flower. So yeah, I used a beautiful paper from Cartabella and I die cutted out the words in glitter cardstock. The bunny that is in the background of the words I received from someone, so I don't know which die it is. I have it for a few years and I kept them and now I finally use them. I put a nice little acrylic bow in its ear and I added some stickers, and these stickers are from a sticker set that I bought here at the local store. That's this one. For my Dutch or European viewers, from the Vibra, that come with these cute little puffy stickers, and that are the stickers I used on these flags. And then of course I made some dangles. I showed them in a craft mix video. I have been making a lot of the small dangles with my nice tool from Temu, from AliExpress, that you can easily make the loops with that pliers. I'm so happy with that. And I attach them with chain so that it hangs a little bit down. Really sweet. So that's the first one. And this you can add to Easter bags, Easter baskets, put on top of a package or on top in the box if you do an Easter swap or something. And of course, I made two. This one has a yellow rabbit and the different word. This is my favorite font from that Easter set. Love it. Again, same stickers, same paper pads, another rose. And here I have three different kind of dangles. Really love this one. It's with a clay bead from Timo. And a cute little wire wrapped rose. It was gifted to me by someone and I added a butterfly on top of a light purple straw. So that are my banners. Had a lot of fun creating this. I really love making these banners. Then I also made some embellishments with a new die set that I received from Caroline Design. And that are the squares. It's just a basic square set. I didn't take it here with me to show you, but it's a basic square set. You get a lot of squares with scallops, big till small. And I decided to make two different kinds of embellishments with those. And I combined that with these ribbon clamps that I had in my stash. These ones. You will all recognize them. There was a time we all made ribbon dangles out of this, so ribbon clusters. But now I wanted to use them in a different way. And I made them as the hanging element of my embellishment. And the first two that I'm going to show you, I made like an Easter ornament, so that you can hang in your Easter branches. Or if you want, just on the packaging, on a bag topper, well, whatever, on the layout. And I just made them out of a few of the small squares from the set from Caroline Design. And I added stickers from my stash and die cuts as well. So I combined die cuts and stickers for this. Did make it a little bit dimensional, of course. And on top I added this rope with some beads. So that is the first one that I did. And the other one is the same. Almost the same. How cute. These ones, the glittery dots, are as well from Case Craft. I don't know if they still have them because I ordered them about a year or two ago. Then I also made these two with a chain between them. And I used a bow from Caroline Design. Made them a little sturdy with a few layers of cardstock and then the patterned paper. And in the same, yeah, these are just the same, only attached to the bow. So yeah, I thought they came out really cute. And what was on here, because I took it out of the package, as you could see, and it was a bag topper that I did. And that one I made as well with the last papers from this Simple Stories pack. It was like this, so really cute gift for someone, for a crafty friend. And yeah, I made a bag topper with the larger squares from the set from Caroline Design. And just combined it with dies from her. I made a Hugelot Ducky. This is a Dutch sentiment, all from Caroline Design. And I combined it with the papers and the chipboard pieces from that Hip Hip Hooray collection. I gave the ducky a metal bow in its hair. And I added some sequins for flower centers. That gives instant texture on your project and I really, really like that. Here I also put a cute little Easter ribbon. You can hardly see it anymore. I had it in my stash for quite some time and I finally used it. And I added some dangles. This one is so cute. It's from BB Craft, the metal egg. It has a gold back. And here I have the word happy. And this one was gifted to me by Wendy, my sweet creative life last year. I thought it matched the papers really well. So that's a bag topper that I did. And then I made two other bag toppers because I was on Facebook Live last week for Caroline Design. And with the squares I made similar bag toppers. And for that I used the Echo Park paper, the little ladybug. Because you will see on these bag toppers are little ladybugs. Look how cute these are. These are as well made with the Hugelot dies. With that die set you can make, well, 15, 16, maybe more, different kind of creatures. Not only animals, also a baby, a fairy. So really sweet. And this time I made it into a ladybug. I did give it a baby, but that's a wooden piece from my stash. I don't know where I got it from. And for the black dots, I only use my black Nouveau drops. In the middle, you see some rosettes. I layered up the rosettes. I also made them with Caroline Design dies, but I do think we all have rosette dies in our stash. And it's a Dutch sentiment. It's a wax seal. That's as well from the last release from Caroline. It says "For you" in Dutch. For the rest, some stickers and die cuts from Caroline as well, and from the paper of Echo Park. And of course, I also needed to put a dangle here. I really like that. And it has a cute little apple from BB Crafts. And I attached the wooden ladybug also on this clothespin. So yeah, thought it came out cute. And this was my example, and this is the one that I did on the Facebook Live. It's exactly the same, only use some different papers and other colors of wax seal. And here I have cute little cherries. I don't know where they are from. They're not from BB Crafts. I think from AliExpress. I have them for a few years now. So that were my three spring summer bag toppers. Then, what do I have more? Yeah, I have a few items more. They are all ATC, so I have two ATC cards and two ATC coins. These are the first ATC coins that I ever made. This I did this because we had that die in the release from Caroline. And, well, I really had a lot of fun. It was a little bit challenging in the beginning, because on an ATC coin you have less space to create than on an ATC card. So yeah, the first one that I did, and I do think I did show this in the video, maybe in a craft mix or in my spring video, I'm not sure, is this one. I did stencil in the background, used a stamp from Caroline, colored it in with my alcohol markers, and yeah, embellished it with sequins, flatback flower, and some yellow Nouveau drops. Thought it came out really cute. It was a series of three, but the other two I am going to exchange with other people. And the next one was this. This is so cute. It's made with also a new die from Caroline. And then I have it. I'm talking about the background. And that's a pixel die. And I didn't take it, but it is interesting for you to see, because I haven't seen it at other craft brands. But I did put it away. And where did I left it? Oh yeah, I have it here. I found it. Look how cute. This is so cute. Do you know the pixel art? I didn't know it before. I know mini stack, I know diamond dust, but there's also pixel art. And when I googled it, yes, it's all around the world. You can find so many examples on Google, on Pinterest, etc. And that is using small little squares to make a cute, or not a cute, to make an image. Or a background, or a full card front. What I did till now is only make use them for the background. But as you can see, this one cuts out a lot of squares. But you also get these ones. They look a little bit like Tetris blocks, I think. And that you can use to make cute little figures combined with this. I think that's a little bit challenging. So till now, I only made them use them as a background. But I thought it came out cute, so I filled it with the squares, and I used a ton sur ton color scheme, so all in pink but three colors of pink. And I didn't have the paper pad with me, but it's not the rainbow, but it's from Lanvin, the textured cardstock, and then the pinks. All the pink hues come in one pack. I love the colors of the Lanvin cardstock. And I thought this came out so cute. Used the die. This was also for the DT for Caroline. So I used the cocktail dies. Look how cute this strawberry is. It's so tiny. And of course I decorated them with a sticker. With some 3D elements. Really had a lot of fun creating these ones. And in that release there is also a new ATC card dies. I made this one. And the nice thing about these ATC dies is that all the dies come with a stitched border, so they're all stitched. The previous ones we had from Caroline were just normal, just plain, and now we have dies with stitching. we have this, so the squares, but there's also one with rounded corners. Here I made a cute little bee one, used the stencil in the background, stems from my stash, and it says, hello, where are my wings? Because, have you seen it? It doesn't have any wings, this bee. So sad, but hey. In the background I also did a little bit of splattering, as you can see, with metallic watercolor. And I really had a lot of fun creating it. This bee is also made with the Hugalot's die. And we also received a die for an envelope that fits the ATC cards perfectly. I made a front and a back, just for the pictures. So this is the front. Stamps, everything is from Carlijn. So it makes a cute little matching envelope. And the last one I'm going to show you is one for a swap. And it's Farm Mail. This is also a die from Carlijn. Yeah, I am in the design team, so I have a lot of dies of that brand, of course. So you will see it on a lot of projects, also if it's not DT related. But I really had a lot of fun creating this. I did a mix, a blend of oxide inks in the background. It's the tumbled glass together with the Kitsch Flamingo. Love that blend. And I added some stenciling with the peacock feathers in the background. Made a cute little snail. I love it so much. It's so adorable. And I used the Josselijne alphabet for the word farm and an old stamp from Alina Crafts, I think. Yeah, I do think it's from Alina of Rokea's Craft. It's a creative stamp set with all creative crafting sentiments. And this was part of a sentiment. And I cut it off and used it here. Cute little bead here. This is a post, how do you call this? The mailbox. Also from KS Craft, I think. It came with a small and a big one from a few years ago. Still love this. And I made paper plane with a die from our local action store, from Craft Sensations. And I thought it came out so cute. It was a series of four, but three of these will go on the mail for the swap. And this one is the one I am going to keep for myself. So yeah, that were all the spring Easter projects that I have for you today. Very curious what you like the most. Tell me in the comments. Had a lot of fun creating this with all the beautiful papers and cute embellishments. Really, Easter spring is really my favorite time to craft together with Christmas. I love Christmas as well. So I just get happy if I see all these happy colors and cute things. Well, yeah, I just really love it. So I'm going to stop right now. I hope you like my video. If you do, please give me a big thumbs up. You can also follow me on social media. I am on Instagram and on TikTok. The links will be in the description box below, as well as my private email. Do you have any questions? Don't hesitate to ask them. Do you want to swap with me? Don't hesitate to ask them. I really want to swap this year, and I haven't got one planned till now. So yeah, let me know if you want to do that. And then I want to thank you for watching, and I hope you will be back for my next video. Bye for now.